Kazan in Tatarstan will host the 2013 Summer Universiade. Its chosen motto, you are the world. At the beginning of April, representatives of 56 nations visited the city, which has built more than 30 venues, especially for the university games. All the big FISU delegations are here. They'll each have 400 or 500 or 600 people even coming to the Universiade. So for them, it's imperative to be here because the visit facilitates the logistical preparations for them, like looking at the accommodation, choosing a place to stay, for example. Sports federations were here from across the globe for the meeting of delegation heads.
Here we go.
They started the visit at the basketball hall, the home venue of the UNICS basketball club. It's a multi-purpose sports facility that regularly hosts high-profile sporting and cultural events. All the venues are at a maximum distance of 15 kilometers from the center. The condition of all the sports facilities, as you can see, meets the very high requirements. I think our Russian team will consist of very strong athletes. And they'll be here at the Universiade, and I hope that their performance will be successful, as good as in previous Universiades. As we say at home, even walls can help. With a capacity of more than 25,000 people and a beautiful position, the athletic stadium is ready to go. We'll come here with 436 people in my delegation, athletes, technical people, representatives, a big staff, because we're candidates in Brazil for the 2019 Universiade. The rowing center is located on the bank of Lake Middle Kazan, a complex designed to FISU standards for international rowing competitions.
I think Germany can earn a lot of medals here in Kazan within the Universiade, and I hope we will be successful in that.
The tour continues. Here we go to the athletes' village.
Allez, suivez-moi en route pour la visite.
Follow me. We're going to visit the building and the rooms where we'll live during the next Universiade in Kazan. We'll try to visit just one room, shall we? So this is the place for the athletes to live and members of the delegations for 2 weeks during the Universiade. It's great, judging from my experience of the past. It corresponds to good standards.
It's a lovely facility and everything is in one building, so you don't have to walk outside to get to the laundry. You don't have to walk far to go to the internet. The internet is all here, and I think it's a good venue. The athletes will enjoy it. It's more of a familiar environment for them. It looks like a university residence, so it will be home away from home.
Yes, the athletes' village will be home to 12,000 competitors, and when it's all over, it's intended that all the venues will be put to good use.
Some of them will remain after Universiade as a legacy for future major international events, but most of them are designed for students, for universities, and the biggest universities will use these venues because Kazan is one of the largest student cities in Russia with more than 100,000 students. So these venues will be home for the future generations of students.
This is the Gymnastics Center, 2,800 square meters, seating for 3,200 spectators. Its ceiling, 18 meters high, complying with all international standards. The Burevestnik Olympic-sized swimming pool is in the Universiade village, the complex including a sports hall and a teaching and training ground.
Kazan seems very much ahead of the game in terms of the preparation of facilities and staff, so we're looking forward to a really successful Games.
The Tennis Academy is one of the largest indoor sports venues in the city. There are 8 indoor and 18 outdoor courts. Every year, the Academy hosts the Kazan Kremlin Cup on the ATP Challenger Tour. The volleyball venue is home to the men's Zenit and the women's Dynamo Kazan volleyball clubs. It's hosted CEV Champions League matches in the past. One of the biggest challenges has been the construction of a football stadium, where the opening ceremony will also be held. The long, hard winter in Kazan slowed down the development, but everyone is working day and night to finish it in time.
We're delayed. The most difficult, the most challenging thing we had here is the roof, because we have a lot of snow. For example, for 1 square meter, we have pressure more than 500 kilos. When we build it, when we finished it, we say, now we're gonna finish the stadium.
Close by is the splendid new aquatic palace where the diving, swimming, and synchronized swimming events will take place. It sits on the bank of the Kazanka River and is one of the largest indoor sports venues in the Russian Federation. It'll serve as the main competition venue during the 2015 FINO World Championships. It was 5 years ago that Kazan won the bid to host the World University Games with its 350 medal events across 27 sports. And now, the action is just weeks away.
That's right.